Banjo Band. I teach people how to play banjo and mandolin and guitar. This is Guitar Week, and we're doing a bag of licks lesson. Yay! These are my favorite because they're your favorite. They're so easy to use. And this week, we're going to learn how to use licks to get us from D to G whenever we're playing our rhythm. I'm going to show you six big ones, and then we're going to learn how to create all kinds of variations using those. If you're watching on Facebook or YouTube, which you probably are, here in a moment, I'll ask you to come over to the website, banjobenclark.com. You can come over there and see this full 30-minute lesson or so. I've got the tabs just like I played them, MP3 jam tracks for you to practice all these rhythm transitions. And then I have hundreds of other lessons that you could check out as well. And don't forget to come by the forum where you can ask questions. Lots of nice people there to help you out, including myself. I'm there every day, so come join us. Let's jump right into this one. Hey, y'all, we're doing a bag of licks lesson today. Everybody loves these, and I love to teach them because they're so very useful. And this one is licks used in your rhythm, particularly, specifically, explicitly, going from the D chord to the G chord. Okay, so anytime that a song has one measure, maybe even a half measure, of D going back to G, you're going to be able to use what I'm teaching today. And what I'm going to teach is six really big licks, just kind of skeletal structure of licks. And then within those, we're going to talk about all kinds of different variations. So even though I'm only teaching six, we're probably going to learn 18 or 24, maybe 27 and a half licks. Let's go ahead and throw up that first line of tab there. And the way that I have these set up is two measures of D going into two measures of G. But the D lick is always happening in the second measure. So that means if you just have one measure of D, this would work just fine. You would just start in the second measure. But the first one we're going to do is called scale up. What I mean by that, I'm not talking about your shower here. I'm talking about using the major scale to walk up to the G note for our chord. So if we're going to do that and start beneath this note, where are we going to start? We're going to start on the low E string and walk right up the scale. Boom, boom, boom. Okay? So we're going to go from here to here, but we're going to play up the scale in between. It's going to sound like this. So that happened, let me play a little slower, maybe you can play along. Cool. Let me put a little Jenga Jenga in there. If you don't know how to put Jenga Jenga in there, then I teach this on the side. Okay. So that sounds pretty cool. Now, what are some ways that we could kind of mess with that to make it a little bit cooler, perhaps? Well, one thing that we could do, we could turn this major scale into a chromatic scale, meaning instead of skipping over that first fret, we could include it. But if we're going to add a note, we need to stretch out the timing a little bit. So we're going to have to come in at a beat earlier. So there in measure two, instead of that strum on the second beat, we're going to go directly down to the E string and then walk up chromatically. It would sound like this. One, two, three, four, one. I'm just going to play all that with my index finger. That's kind of a cool way to manipulate that. And of course, you can always do little hammer-ons too. Go back to the way that the lick is originally written. And instead of going right into that third fret on the third measure, we could hammer into it from the second to third fret. You hear that a lot in bluegrass. It would sound like this. Just hammer on that first beat of measure three. Pretty cool. Now let's move on to the next one. This one we're going to call scale down, which is what you should do to your shower. As you guessed, we're going to use this major scale to not walk up to the G note, but to walk down. So we're going to start above it. So there, measure six, we see this. Start with that D note, and then we're going to walk right down the scale. Pretty cool, huh? Sounds like this. If I can play the right notes, we'll try it again. Okay, that sounds pretty simple, but you know what? I love the simple stuff, especially when you're going fast. It's better to be simple many, many times, okay? So I know we're going kind of slow, but these things really work when you're up tempo as well. Now, what are some ways that we can kind of mess with this? Well, you could, if you had two measures of D, you could stretch out this lick. And so instead of in measure six having those quarter notes, one, two, three, four, you can make them all half notes. So you could start the walk all the way back in measure five and put strums in between them. It would sound like this slowly. Now, whenever you do that, you're gonna have to release this E string. So if you strum all the way through, you're gonna get that E note. So what you can do is just abbreviate your strumming and just catch those inside strings. Yeah, if I can do it. Okay. Now another thing that you can do to spice that up even is you could hammer on into each of these scale notes from the open A string. Okay, so it'd sound like this. I forgot you could even pull off into that open A string, it would sound even cooler. It'd sound like this. That's a speed. That sounds pretty cool. So there's a lot of different variations that we can get from this scale down. Now, if you're watching on Facebook or YouTube, here, I'm gonna ask you to come over to my site. If you're already on my site, let's go to the next video segment. We'll look at how to use the G run to work into these rhythm licks and much more.